Missionary aviation is important, and I've seen it firsthand. I was a missionary for 10 years in Africa.
To be a missionary pilot, not only do you have to be a pilot, you have to be a mechanic as well.
Very difficult to get around. What we're doing is we're going into the unreached people groups, and they're the hardest to reach people. We need aviation to get them in and out.
Many parts of the world, they use dirt two tracks or tributaries of rivers and deltas, and to get around takes a lot of time in a canoe or a four-wheel drive truck.
So I have a friend out in the bush in Africa, and it took 3 days to drive out to his place, whereas it took an hour and a half to fly there.
By using the airplane, one pilot in an airplane can save many, many man hours and multiply the efforts of many missionaries. Today, there's a need for more missionary aviation pilots and maintenance personnel that work on these airplanes.
We're missions oriented. Our objective is to train people for missionary aviation.
Training young men and women to serve in aviation and mechanics, to serve in foreign countries as they need pilots and mechanics.
This airport is relatively small, has tree-lined runways, so the students get used to seeing things close to them as they land the airplane and develop their skills.
You get used to having to use short field approach techniques to land out here, and you get used to seeing obstacles at the end of your runway.
The winds are a little bit difficult sometimes, and it makes it a unique airport to train for missions.
The time is a big factor. There are not very many airframe and power plant schools that can be completed in 1 year.
We divide our time 50% in the classroom and 50% in hands-on lab. We try to explain the theory in the classroom, and then we give them a demonstration of how to perform the task, the lab project.
So it's a variety. There are 43 different topics that the students cover.
The general section has classes like basic electricity, basic hydraulics, math, physics, basic prerequisite classes. The airframe third of the course is airframe systems like instruments and control surfaces. And then the last third of the year is power plants, where we deal with turbine engines and reciprocating engines, engine overhaul.
It really boiled down to the people and the staff here at the school, and they're the ones who made the difference.
The thing that impressed me most about SMAT was just probably the instructors.
The teachers, you can call them on them anytime. If I had a problem other than school, they'd be there for me.
The faculty and the staff offer a pretty broad range of aviation experience, from air taxi work and rebuilding and flight school work.
Half the staff has served up in Alaska for a long period of time, and you can't get any more bush than what you find up in Alaska. So. When they bring in their experience, they can say, hey, we've been there when there's no tools, and this is how we make it happen.
That's one thing we look for in people that work here, is we want people who are committed to missions and committed to the Lord, but also committed to seeing these students improve and taking them from wherever they are in their lives to the next level.
They know so much about airplanes and about life, and you get all you could want and more.
We're not in the business of just cranking out airframe and power plant mechanics into the general public. We want to disciple our guys and train them up spiritually by being examples. We're not a Bible school or a theological school, but we lead our guys spiritually by example.
The ultimate goal is to see them blossom and mature and be useful of the Lord in a missionary aviation field.
I would definitely recommend it to a lot of people. I would say it's for a person who's definitely very self-motivated and who has structure in their life and is willing to expect the unexpected.
But this school just made all the difference when you eventually, when we talked to the staff and you heard their stories and you heard how they want to disciple people towards Christ, and just their love for the students made it worth coming here.
If anyone were to consider SMAT as a school, I would recommend that they visit and see who we are. I think that we got some of the best teachers, instructors, and staff anywhere.